Hey guys, welcome to another Warframe video, and I've been pretty busy forming the heck out of my Cora setup so that I can fit the Umbral mods onto my Cora and the Sacrificial mods onto my Nakana Zoe. So now that I'm done with the kind of amplification of my Cora, I want to talk about it a little bit, as well as talk about using the Umbral and Sacrificial mods on normal gear in general. And let's start it off with Cora. So as you can see, I've polarized every single slot that I could, and I also repolarized the aura slot into a V so I can put in steel charge, which gives you more mod capacity than any other aura. Now, the reason why I haven't brought Umbral Fiber and Umbral Vitality one rank higher, just like Intensify, even though I do have 2 mod capacity remaining, is because I'm gonna get the Prime Sure-Footed mod in about 40 days, and that drains more capacity than Handspring right now. So at that point, once I do get it and max it out, I will drop Hunter Adrenaline for Rage, which will give me 1 extra mod capacity, which will allow me to fit in Prime Sure-Footed instead of Handspring. Also, I'm kind of out of credits and endo and Ayatan sculptures and Ayatan stars in general, because these are basically primed mods and we got 5 of them at once. But then again, even if I did have the endo and credits, I still couldn't rank them up because they just wouldn't fit anymore. But even though they're not maxed out, Umbral Vitality still gives me 630% extra health as opposed to 440, which you get from a maxed out Vitality. Umbral Fiber gives 157.5 extra armor as opposed to 110 extra armor, which you get from maxed out Steel Fiber. But the biggest one is definitely Umbral Intensify, which gives me 60% ability strength rather than 30%, which you get from normal Intensify, which is actually 5 more than a maxed out Transient Fortitude. Then I also formatted my Bewitched Alone Sword, which is a Nakana Zoa, to fit in Sacrificial Pressure and Sacrificial Steel. Now, while this will require one more format, which is going to be a V where Spoiled Strike is, to max them out, it's going to take a long time, because once again, these are primed mods, so they take an immense amount of credits and endo to bring to the final rank. And this is sort of just my quick attack weapon, as well as a stat stick for my Whipclaw. Now, with this setup, so both of them on and being one rank from the top, Sacrificial Steel is an absolutely humongous upgrade over the standard True Steel, because it gives a 100% crit chance rather than 60. And while Sacrificial Pressure isn't as good as Prime Pressure Point, which gives you 165% bonus generic melee damage, it boosts Sacrificial Steel. If I take it off, I will lose about 7% crit, because Sacrificial Steel will drop down to 80% crit chance rather than 100. And just in case you didn't think I was crazy enough, I'm also running a 5 form of Anari, because I decided to take out the ability polarity to fit in Benipet Kit, and I finally switch into an Adarza Kavat, where I have 7 forma. Well, it's actually 6, because I had to reformat one of the polarities since I was running a different build and didn't like it quite as much as this one. So was this actually worth it in the end? You know, worth all the forma, all the endo, all the credits, and the time? Because it took quite a while to put this together. I'm gonna go with a yes, but only for setups that will take full advantage of all the mods. I honestly wouldn't do it on most frames. I'm not even going to do it on my Inaros, even though it would be hilarious to run around with about 8,500 health, simply because the Umbral Intensify doesn't do anything for my lazy tank setup. I wouldn't do it on Rhino, Loki, Ashe, Ember, Banshee, Vauban, probably Wukong as well. I would maybe do it on my Sarin, because I like to do Sanctuary Onslaught with her, so the idea of having more health, more armor, and more power strength is pretty cool. But as I've said, I don't think this is worth doing on most frames. But that's not the only issue that surfaces when you do this, you know, it being too expensive for what it does. It also significantly narrows your mod choices, because you have to polarize everything around these mods to fit them in and have them at a decent rank. Which means that I wouldn't just do it on frames that don't benefit all 3 of the mods, I also wouldn't do it on frames where I have multiple setups, because chances are, once I get all the polarities in, I just won't be able to swap different mods in to use the different builds. The one thing you could do, and what I probably would have done if I could do this again, is I would max out Umbral Intensify, because it's just so much better than the normal Intensify, and I would leave Umbral Vitality and Umbral Fiber at a lower rank, somewhere where it's basically just as strong as the normal Vitality and normal Steel Fiber. That way you have more capacity to play around with, so it's not as restrictive, and you're also getting the biggest benefit of these, which is a massive amount of bonus power strength from the Umbral Intensify. Or you could just use 2 of them maxed out, which would be Umbral Intensify most definitely, and probably Umbral Vitality, which would still at that point be better than their normal counterparts. That would actually fit few more frames, and it would be way less of a pain in the backside to actually slot into the builds. And as far as the Sacrificial mods are concerned, I don't think these are terribly worth the investment, unless you're fighting the Sentients, because you do get bonus Sentient damage from each one of them, or it takes way too long for your weapon to reach red crit territory with the blood rush, or you know, you're doing a quick attack build, or you're using it as a stat stick like I'm doing over here. And it's all because we have primed pressure point, which is better than sacrificial pressure, so if you don't need the crit or the sentient damage, it's better if you use something else. Though then again, sacrificial steel is better than true steel even if you don't have sacrificial pressure, so you might as well use it instead of true steel if you have the former. So once again, just like with the Umbral mods, it can be worth it, it's just very specific to the weapon you're using and what you're doing with that weapon. So just like with the Umbral mods, I don't think this is worth using on most melee weapons. It's actually worse than the Umbral mods because you can spend way more forma to actually cripple the damage of your weapon with these. So in conclusion, these mods are worth using on certain warframes and certain weapons. However, even if you are willing to put in the time, the effort, the resources, I would still think about it twice because it may not be as big of a difference as you might think. Yes, you are going to have more health, you're gonna have more armor, and you're gonna have more power strength, so your abilities are gonna be stronger. But it's not going to be sort of out of this world, it's not gonna make your Loki's decoy suddenly one-shot the juggernaut. And the same goes for the sacrificial mods, you're gonna have more crit, that's pretty much it, assuming that you do have primed pressure point already. If not, you're gonna have a little bit more damage as well. And it's also going to be really expensive, not just in terms of the forma you have to put on the gear, but also, you know, the credits and endo you're going to sink into these mods that you're honestly not really going to use on too much gear. So what I'm saying is I would basically only recommend it to people like me, people that have done pretty much everything and have, well, nothing else to do. And that's pretty much it, so I thank you very much for watching. As always guys, I hope you've enjoyed the video, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.